On December 11, 1972, Apollo 17 lands on the lunar surface. It was the final moon landing mission of NASA's Apollo program, and remains the most recent time humans have traveled beyond low Earth orbit, and also recent time humans have stepped foot on the moon. Now, almost after 5 decades, this idea of landing humans on the moon is gaining popularity, thanks to the Elon Musk SpaceX low-cost rocket technology. Even Elon Musk planning to send humans back on moon, and to build a moon base before sending humans to Mars. So stay with us to know what are the plans of Elon Musk to build a moon base before Mars base. Elon Musk is a billionaire entrepreneur and business magnate. He is a CEO and chief engineer at SpaceX, CEO and product architect of Tesla, and founder of many companies. Elon is on the mission of building a self-sustaining city on Mars using his inexpensive advanced rocket technology. But he wants to build a moon base before Mars base. As he said, moon first, Mars as soon as planets align. He also said we should have a base on the moon, like a permanently occupied the human base on the moon, and then send people to the Mars.
Been now almost half a century since humans were last on the moon. It's too long. We need to get back there and have a permanent base on the moon. I think a big permanently occupied base on the moon, and then build a city on Mars and become a spacefaring, spacefaring civilization, a multi-planet species.
His company, SpaceX or Space Exploration Technologies Corporation, was founded in 2002 with the goal of reducing the cost of space transportation. In last 19 years, SpaceX launched over 120 orbital space flights, deployed over 1,500 Starlink communication satellites into the space. SpaceX also manufactured the Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy launch vehicles, many rocket engines including Merlin and Raptor engines, Dragon cargo and crewed spacecraft, and 10 prototypes of their new rocket called Starship. SpaceX is rapidly advancing Starship development, drawing on an extensive history of launch vehicle and engine development program. Starship is a fully reusable spacecraft which requires a super heavy booster to reach Earth orbit. Starship will be capable of delivering up to 150 tons of payload to Moon and 100 tons of payload to Mars at the lowest cost. SpaceX planned for Starship orbital flight as early as July 2021. And once Starship will be fully developed, SpaceX will use it for their every mission, from orbital transportation to deep space missions, because of its launch cost will be very low. NASA also announced they have selected Starship to land astronauts on a lunar surface for the Artemis space program. Artemis space program is a United States-led international human spaceflight program, aiming to return humans to the moon, specifically lunar south pole region, by the year 2024. But SpaceX will probably start building base before sending humans to the red planet, which is before 2024. They can even start building moon base from today. Their Falcon Heavy can transport over 30 tons of payload to the moon. They can send robots to set up solar panels and propellant plant on the moon on the Falcon Heavy. They can also send 3D printers that can print habitats on the moon, just like a space factory's Marsha and rovers to study composition of the lunar surface. But Falcon Heavy is not fully reusable, and Elon Musk is focusing more on development of Starship. NASA awarded SpaceX $2.9 billion to develop and manufacture a lunar lander variant of Starship for landing humans to the lunar surface. This modified Starship will have no body flaps and heat shields, because there's no atmosphere on Moon and the Starship will not return back to Earth. This Starship will have a special landing thrusters to land and launch safely from the lunar surface. It will also act as a living space and communication system for early astronauts. Lunar base would require a wide variety of equipment, including production equipment. Required equipment will include basic utilities such as oxygen production for breathing and propellant, communication system to communicate with Earth and for local communication, power infrastructure, landing pads, waste disposal, and water recycling for early base. Later, they can extract clean water from lunar ice. Other required equipments are habitats, airlock for pressurization, local resource extraction equipment, food production, propellant production, spacesuits and crewed rovers. That's a lot of equipment. Still, Musk can provide most of these equipment without relying on other companies to provide equipment for moon base. Elon Musk's SpaceX can provide transportation and communication system. Starship can transport up to 150 tons of payload or over 150 people to moon. He can send his starships to the moon every week, because it takes just 3 days to reach moon from the Earth. And Elon plans to produce over 100 starships every year. So if he will send 200 starships every week to the moon, there will be over 1.5 million tons of payload or over 1.5 million people on the lunar surface in just a year. SpaceX's Starlink constellation can provide fast and continuous communication of astronauts with Earth. SpaceX can also provide their advanced spacesuits for moon base. Elon's biggest company, Tesla, can provide their solar panels and their energy storage technology for moon base. Tesla is developing Cybertruck, which can be used as a rover on the moon, because it is powered by electricity and it is made of super hard cold rolled stainless steel, so it can tolerate the 300 degrees Celsius difference in the temperature of the lunar surface. Musk's another company called the Boring Company can also provide equipment for the moon base. Their drilling technology can build underground habitats to protect astronauts from radiation and meteorites. They can also use this technology to create infrastructure on the moon and for mining on the moon. There is almost unlimited supply of lunar ice on moon. Elon can extract water from the lunar ice for drinking and growing plants on the moon. Water can be split into hydrogen and oxygen. Hydrogen can be used as energy source on the moon, and oxygen as propellant for the starship and for life supporting system on the moon. Elon can extract rare earth metals from the lunar surface and transport it to the Earth. He can also start production of solar panels on the moon, as there is abundance of silicon available on the moon in the form of silica. There is extremely valuable resource on the moon, which is helium-3. Helium-3 is one moon resource that is very rare on Earth, which cost about $140 million per kilogram, but much more abundant on the lunar surface, and could potentially be cheaper to mine from the moon. Helium-3 is a very attractive fuel for nuclear fusion reactors. 25 tons of helium-3 can power United States for an entire year, and there is over 1 million tons of helium-3 present on the moon. This amount of helium-3 can power our civilization for hundreds of years. Mining of helium-3 will accelerate the advancement in the technology of nuclear fusion. So Elon can build a self-sustaining city on the moon through his companies. But there is a big problem in the building a lunar base, which is a propellant production for his starships. Starship is powered by liquid methane and liquid oxygen. Production of oxygen is easy on moon, but production of methane is extremely difficult, because there is almost no source of carbon available on the lunar surface. As Elon said, that big challenge for a starship refueling on the moon is finding sources of carbon. Probably some pretty big deposit in craters from meteorites. Same goes for hydrogen and oxygen also, and shadow craters. Other solution to this problem is to send tankers of carbon dioxide from the Earth to the moon. Carbon dioxide will be used to produce methane on the moon using subatomic process. Another solution is to put carbon-rich asteroids on the moon's orbit for mining, in order to produce methane on the lunar surface. Once the self-sustaining moon city will fully developed, there will be a lot of customers on the Earth for lunar space tourism. In my SpaceX's plans for space tourism video, I told you that lunar space tourism ticket will cost from over $20,000 to $100,000. Which is very cheap in comparison to the current $20 million ticket to International Space Station. SpaceX planned to mass produce 1,000 starships. These starships will provide lunar space tourism to the millions of people in the future. This will inspire people to stay and work on the moon. I hope this video get you excited about the future. Like the video, comment down your views about the video. Share this video to support my channel and subscribe for more videos. Support my